Dear learners, let us learn some more concepts related with the circle. You are very much familiar that the circle is the collection of all points in a plane which are at a constant distance from a fixed point in the same plane. This fixed point is center of the circle. Now see this portion, this colored portion is known as interior of the circle. The outside is exterior of the circle, and this place is known as on the circle. Let me take a point R on the circle. Whenever the point R is on the circle, the distance of this point from the center will always be equal to the radius of the circle. See, radius of the circle is 4.5. The distance of point R from the center is also 4.5, which is equal to the radius of the circle. Let me take the point R inside the circle. Now see, the distance of point R from the center OR is 3.37, which is less than the radius. As long as the point R remains inside this circle, the distance of this point R from the center will always be less than 4.5, the radius of the circle. Now let me take it outside. When the point R is outside, the distance OR, that means the distance of the point R from the center, will be greater than the radius of the circle. It is obvious from the figure. The movement of point R shows as long as it is inside, the distance is less than 4.5. When it is outside the circle, distance of the point from the center is more than the radius. Take two points P and Q on the circle. Draw a line segment joining these points P and Q. This line segment PQ is known as chord of the circle. Move this point P. As this chord approaches towards the center, see the length of the line segment PQ, that means the chord increases, and when it passes through the center, the length of the chord becomes equal to double of the radius, and when it moves away from the center, the length of the chord decreases. So when it passes through the center, the length of the chord is maximum, and this is known as diameter of the circle. So diameter of the circle is the chord which passes through the center of the circle. The diameter of the circle divides the circle into two equal parts. Observe this red portion in the circle. This red portion of the circle is known as arc. See, the diameter divides the circle into two parts, and this red portion is less than the half part of the circle. This is known as minor arc. And the portion of the circle which is more than the half of the circle, shown by green color, that is known as major arc. Now, semicircle is exactly half part of the circle. Half part of the circle means half arc, which is made by the diameter, that is known as semicircle. So the diameter divides the circle into two equal arcs, each of which is known as semicircle. Now observe this portion of the circle. This portion of the circle is made up by an arc of the circle, the two radii at the end of the arc. This portion is known as sector of the circle. Now, the sector of the circle made by the major arc is known as major sector. Take a point M on the circle. Let the point M move. The point M is moving along the boundary of the circle. Let it make a complete rotation. When it comes back to its original position, it has completed just one round around the boundary of the circle. The total length covered by point M is known as circumference of the circle. Hence, the length of the boundary of a circle is known as circumference of the circle.